We're at the RSPB's Fairburn Ings Nature Reserve, and we're up on what's called Fairburn Tips, which is an old coal tips. And we're standing on what used to be the coal tips trail, but today we're renaming it to the Roy Taylor Trail after our colleague Roy Taylor, who passed away last year. Roy was massively important to me personally. I can still remember the first day I met him. I think probably most people can. Roy is absolute force of nature, a force for nature. Just a hugely kind of compelling personality and an amazing nature conservationist who got so much stuff done. I wouldn't be standing here talking to you today if it wasn't for Roy and, you know, the kind of support that he gave me. He's played an absolutely massive part in my life and lives of loads of my colleagues as well. So it's a really important day for us.
Certainly from my point of view, that the fact that it is now the Roy Taylor Trail is a big thing for me, because the man was an inspiration and one of the reasons that I'm with the RSPB. So I think that's a great honour that we've got a trail named after him, and the fact that we've now got a circular route that takes in what it does and is accessible to lots and lots of people, I think that's exceptional as well.
And superb views.
Yes.
Looking both ways, sort of northwards into the countryside and then back towards Castleford to the kind of industrial past, it feels like, in terms of, you know, where the reserve is.
The coal tips has been part of Fairburn Ings Nature Reserve for many years, but during that time we didn't have the kind of best management arrangement over the site. Roy, being the kind of sensible headed guy that he was, he'd sort of identified that was something that we really needed to resolve, and he sort of put that process in train, really got it going, you know, really kind of kick-started it. So that this year, with sort of generous funding from Biffa Award and some further funding from Ecotricity, we were able to purchase the land that we're standing on, so, you know, able to secure it for nature conservation and for sort of all generations to come. During Roy's time here, we sort of upgraded the path network, put in a lot of the fencing that you can see, which has allowed us to graze the site. And I think kind of most importantly, and probably kind of most dear to Roy's heart, it allows people of, I guess, like all abilities in every sense of the word to get up here and experience the sort of amazing wildlife up here, the spectacular views. It's a fantastic, integral part of the nature reserve here. Coal mining was obviously a massive part of the landscape and the communities here, and the tips that we're standing on is basically a big spine of colliery waste which came out of the various coal mines in the area. So it's great now that we've got the chance to kind of reshape it into something that's, you know, a fantastic resource for people and for the local communities and for visitors and obviously for wildlife as well.